Hello, dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today to welcome you back to Undervault here in the game Banished, where we have some brand new projects underway. A trading post has been established, and the resources are nearly ready to start on actual building. This is the only place I could fit it. It's not ideal. It's a bit of an awkward position, but that's where it can go, so that's where it shall. Over to the right, we have spots for two mines and a quarry, which leads me to talk about one of the things that I despised previously in Banish. I hate how these two locations just end up littering the landscape. Quarries run out of stone and mines run out of ore far too quickly for my taste, and you end up just scattering quarries here and there and mines surrounding mountains, and it just becomes a nuisance. It may be realistic in some respects, but I don't like it. So as a result, I have added a new mod that makes the resources within these locations unlimited. Is it cheating? Yes, it is. But does it make the game more fun for me? Yes, it does. So in that case, I think it's completely okay. And if you'd like to try that out for yourself while playing Banished, feel free to check out the link below to find it on Steam Workshop. Now, what we're going to be doing now is just kind of waiting and watching while the trading post finishes up. And the reason that this is important is because we need some seeds, we need some animals. That's how we're going to get access to all the new things that we want to check out from the mods. I mean, there's more than just that, but we need a bit of an infrastructure first. Ideally, my first goal is to get some cows, because I'd like to try making some bread and milk. We'll see how that goes, though. For now, I'm going to go ahead and resume construction on yet another home so that we can start increasing our population. I love having kind of all these things set up and ready to go, and why not go ahead and have a bridge constructed as well? And before I do that, let's take a look at the new stone bridge, because who needs this crappy wooden bridge when you have a sweet-looking stone bridge? Now, I had to find it first. Here it is. It takes 5 units of stone per length. I like that quite a bit, so we're going to delete this old, nasty wooden bridge. And let's find a great spot. I want 2 stone bridges to crisscross here. Where can they go? Italics, the decision that he always has to make, and he never can, is exactly where these buildings should go. Okay, so if a road's going to be here eventually, I want it to connect to the bridge. That makes sense, right? So let's have bridge number 1 over here. And there's going to be another road coming in here, but it's going to be interrupted by the blacksmith. That's okay. So I'm going to place another kind of nearby, like so. There we go. And it appears that the trading post is done. We need at least 1 worker here. So we want to make the maximum 6 like we have. We'll have 1 person working at the trading post, and now some little boats can come by and offer us their goods. And I guess I could set some things up to purchase if I really wanted them. Or order, I guess. I don't know how to, I forgot how this works. I never use this feature. That's kind of the issue. We'll ignore that for now and pretend like it doesn't exist. Oh my goodness, these stone bridges have appeared out of seemingly nowhere. They don't look terrible. The top one looks much better than the bottom one, unfortunately. I don't like the way that these two are different sizes. You know, these little arches. That's gonna bother me. But if I just look at it from this direction, it's fine. It looks great. Just close your eyes, take a deep breath, and pretend. Let's take a quick look back at the abbey which we built previously. I want to see how it's doing. Looks like in the previous season, we produced 10 ale. In this season, we've produced 10 ale. So I guess it's just a constant supply of 10, which obviously isn't that much, but it should be increasing the happiness of our population at least a little bit. So I'm just gonna keep them doing that for now. I feel like they're not going to produce much of any particular resource, but a little bit is helpful nonetheless. So I'm curious about this new building, the apiary. It's used to keep bees and generate honey. It takes 54 logs, 24 stone. Seems like a good new building, and we have all this room to work with over here. What is this? A herbalist. Okay, good. We've got a forester's lodge over here as well. I completely forgot that I placed those down, to be perfectly honest with you. All right, you know, we'll have another little settlement kind of going on over here. I want to make sure we assign some workers to these tasks. So let's get, we've got 8 foresters right now? Okay. We'll just make that up to 9. I think that's going to be good to start off with, because we only have 1 extra laborer at the moment, and that is not ideal. All right, where was I? The apiary. All right, how do we want to kind of lay this town out? I always like to look and see how big a market is going to be, because if a market can fit firmly in between these two buildings, that is ideal. So what I'm going to do is kind of have the market go down right here and pause it so we don't start constructing it yet. And I want to remove the herbalist somewhere else, I think. Maybe at least one spot back a little bit further. I'm just not going to worry about it right now because we made another one anyway. We don't even need that building. I'm getting sidetracked. But these are all important considerations to keep in mind. Okay, so the apiary, let's kind of make it sort of close to the barn so they can cross the little bridge and get to the depository nice and easily. I want to make two wide roads. And I guess this spot is as good as any. There we go. I have so much trouble figuring out where to put everything, guys. When I can decide that quickly, that's an achievement all on its own. You have to understand. Now, back over here on the other side, I want to check on construction of these two buildings. Most of the resources have been put in for iron, for the quarry. However, we might be running low on logs and stone. You know what that means? It's time to clean out yet another area, removing some more resources. So let's nab some trees, which I don't know where we should cut them down. I'm assuming like in this area, because we're going to be using this for construction and building anyway. So let's go ahead and have them cut a bunch of these down, and I can put... We've got the Forester's Lodge out here anyway. They're going to be actively replanting. Really not concerned about that. As winter is upon us, I've had to put our construction projects on hold temporarily so that our laborers can go out here, gather lumber like this gentleman, Raid, is doing, taking it back to town so that our woodcutter, just in the nick of time, can make some firewood for our homes to make sure that they stay warm. And we have a merchant who has arrived at the trading post. And he has for us some seeds for a potential orchard. How are we going to get 2,500 worth of any one item here? That's kind of the question. We have an abundance of tools. We have 50 stored tools. You know what? We're going to put them all in. Or at least 40 of them, I think, is a good number. So we're going to start taking those down. What else do we have in excess of? Herbs, but I don't think we're really using them that much. They're never really good for trading. But we'll take them down anyway, just in case. Let me find our workers here and see what they are carrying. Okay, you are carrying logs. Please start gathering something else, because I actually have work for you to do. You can only carry two tools at a time in that huge wheelbarrow. Those tools must be for Godzilla. I can't imagine any other circumstance in which a whole wheelbarrow would be used for two tools. All right, you guys might want to work on that. We need some higher level carrying capacity here. What do you have? He has 38 tools. So what's wrong with your defective wheelbarrow? Raid. I thought you were working for me, but clearly you're trying to hobble me. All right, well, at least this guy's got it under control. Let's see how much tools are worth in the trading menu. They're worth 8 apiece. So if I put them all in, that gets us only... We're not going to be able to afford it, guys. He's not going to take either of these two things. We're just going to have to let those seeds fly. And now that the apiary is almost done, we'll have an extra source of food. I love seeing the little frameworks pop up for these new buildings. It's really just cool to watch. I've always enjoyed that. And I also want to go ahead and resume construction on another house because we need to bump up the population pretty quickly. All right, let's change this. It's already at 10 times speed. You guys are probably really amazed that I'm playing at 10 times speed. Because if you watched all 36 of my previous videos on Banished, you'll know I love playing at like 2x speed and watching what everyone from Portez to Alicette is doing at any given point in time. But this time, I'm in it to see the new stuff. And here we have the apiary with up to 2 people working in it. And I love that you can see all the little details from the beehives covered up by the little roofs. And here's where they work on the inside and this little barn-like structure. And it's hopefully going to be a good source of food for us. I don't know. How much can we actually get from honey? It's interesting to find out. Oh, look, you can even see the little honeycomb on the ground of the apiary after they've gathered it with what appears to be a plow. They're just jamming that plow up into the beehive and scraping out whatever they can find. Is this his whole family here? Just hanging. Oh, you're gathering the honeycomb and you're going to take it back to the barn. How nice. How much honeycomb is that? 24. We're starting to run a bit low on food. If you may recall, we had 3,000. Now we're down to 2,000. Need to nip this in the bud. So I've got the Abbey now producing blueberries for us. Don't know how much that's actually going to help. But Having someone else to work in the apiary would certainly be nice. But there's no one to work. We have no laborers. What could we possibly get rid of? Obviously, the builders are not doing anything in the meantime. We only need one builder at a time. Let's add another person at the apiary so that we can generate even more food. And I'm looking down the row here, and I'm not really seeing anybody. I guess stonecutters. We don't need two stonecutters. I don't know. We're kind of running into a bit of a standstill here. No new people. We're still running low on lumber. Alex is going to have to figure out what to do. Seems like the apiary's doing pretty good. We've got over 240 honeycomb plucked from the hives this season so far. And we're doing all right. I want to make some more new buildings like this. At least one more for this video. I would love to make the colonial houses, but we need rope for that. And for a rope, we need a ropery. And for ropery, we need textile plants, which I think means we need hemp. Now, I don't know if we start with any of the new materials, like the new crops, or if we have to get them from a trader. So I am going to do some experimentation, and we are going to make a little farm, a little cropland. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, a road, and then the farm. Yes, I have to count it out like that every single time. And we want to make sure a road can go all the way around the crop field just because I like that. And there we have it. We're going to have them remove all the trees, the iron, the rocks, anything that might be in the way there. That'll be a good first spot. And I might build a bridge. Yes, a bridge right here. And then have another crop field kind of across the stream from it. So 14 by 11 sounds good to me. And let's place the entrance on this side right here. Looks good. So I know this is going to be encroaching upon our little base of operations, but I think they still have plenty of room to work with. And the Forester's Lodge should be planting plenty of new trees so that the hunting cabin, the gatherers, whoever needs those trees, the herbalists and whatnot, are still good to go. So there's the bridge all done. We have plenty of access points to get from one side to the other. We may not be able to grow hemp or make rope or anything like that yet, but we can make a silkworm hut, which I'm gonna place right here. Hopefully that is a good spot. There's enough room for a road in between and all the way around the market. And the reason I'm making a silkworm hut is, first of all, it's a new building, and I love seeing these new buildings pop up. But also because I think the silkworm hut can kind of generate resources on its own. It doesn't require anything from the trader in order to function, which is, of course, appealing to me. So I guess whatever it... I wonder if we can trade things that we make from here. Can we trade, like, honey, for example? I would assume so. Yes, you can. Pretty excited that we are about to finish our initial town square of 12 houses. The final one is being built now. Just needs a tiny bit more stone before it's done. And I have resumed construction on the quarry, which is nearly complete. We're going to be able to have an infinite source of stone from here, thank goodness, because we're completely out of just countryside stone. I also want to be able to make some more houses around here. I wanted some colonial houses from the colonial mod, but they require rope, as you know. We can make some medium stone houses, which look just like this, from the fountain mod, however, which does not need any new materials. It just needs quite a bit of pre-existing ones. So I think it's a wise idea to make a little house perhaps next to the lodge. And I think this is enough space. One in between. That'll work. And we'll kind of have that go in simultaneously. I think we can go ahead and accept materials to it without taking from anything else at the moment. And the house is done around the town square. So even more people going to be born here. I think we're good on food. We got almost 4,000. That's really good. Meanwhile, over at the quarry, our one town builder is done. He is a pro. He knows how to construct every single building. This is your man, Ulysio. He's 68 years old, but don't let that fool you. He's built like an ox. He built this whole quarry by himself. A very impressive feat, I might add. So we need at least two people working here. Sad as that may be, it only leaves us with one laborer. We're gonna need way more than two people gathering stone for us, but at least somebody's down here. And as usual, we have the old women as miners. Ooh, and over here, back at the new town square, the silkworm hut is being built. So we can watch the framework go up right next to the apiary, and we'll have our second new building going up here. Let's check on the medium stone house. It needs, you guessed it, stone, because we got none. Everything's here at the silkworm hut, ready to go, though. while we're waiting, let's look at the apiary. It's made almost 1,000 honey the previous season, and 2 logs. Where did they get those logs from? Are those wood bees? Moments before this silkworm hut is complete, we don't have enough people to assign workers to make silk cocoons or silk worms. I think cocoons is what we want. I think worms are what you eat. Either way, guys, everything's looking nice. We got some basic buildings like the quarry and the mine put up that we really needed, really, to have this town sustained. We've got the apiary putting out tons of honey for us every season as food, and the silkworm hut making those silk cocoons, which we're going to have to worry about weaving into even better materials, maybe even ones that we can trade in the future. We'll have to build the weavers next time. I hope you guys are enjoying what you've been seeing so far in the return of Banished here in Underbold. Thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.